The story of a man who wouldn't back down in his pursuit of the American dream.
The Hulk?
Yeah.
Yeah, he's right here. Hold the tiger! Hold the tiger!
What is it?
Hold the tiger! Hold the tiger!
Preston Tucker was born in Capac, Michigan in 1903. Even as a boy, he was fascinated by the new automobile. As he grew, he had the dream of creating the safest car with features that were decades ahead of its time. Since there were any government regulations for safety on the roads, car accidents were common. So then, he began designing the Tucker car.
Which do you think the public would rather buy? The same old models Detroit has been giving us before the war, or the car of tomorrow? Today.
Whoa!
When the blueprint was finished, Tucker and his team started creating a model of the very first prototype. There were three headlights. Two outside were standard lights with a new middle headlight called Cyclops that could change direction with the wheels. The engine was in the rear opposed to the front due to weight distribution. It also had pop-out front windshields. In case of a crash, the glass could come out in two pieces to prevent it from shattering all over the passengers. The team had many trials and errors building prototypes. Eventually, they created a rolling chassis that he could drive. Tucker had limited time to present the car, so his team was running around, working 24/7, with no sleep. In 1948, at the Tucker Corporation in Chicago, Preston debuted the first Tucker with his family. Everyone loved it. However, there were news critics that thought otherwise. They wrote that the Tucker was unsafe, would not be able to outperform the other cars, and that parts were from a junkyard. It would not live up to the promise that Tucker initially stood for.
To prove his critics wrong, Tucker created seven prototypes to perform test trials at the Indianapolis 500 Speedway in September of 1948. To the news critics' surprise, the Tucker outperformed every statistic of the modern-day car of that time. A test driver even survived a horrific car rollover, which would have killed him in any other car. The driver got out of the Tucker with only an elbow bruise, and the car was still running. So Tucker accidentally proved that his car was the safest car in America, as well as having the most technological advances. On a side note, this is car number 28, which is sitting right in front of you on the museum floor. Tucker made history and changed cars forever. All of his success was getting the attention of Detroit. Threatened by his revolutionary ideas, Detroit lobbyists may have urged the Securities and Exchange Commission in Washington to investigate. The government accused Tucker of misusing the $26 million he raised from stockholders for the production of Tucker cars. The lawsuit against Tucker and the bad publicity would be the downfall of his company.
But a big business closes the door on the little guy with a new idea, we're not only closing the door on progress, but we're sabotaging everything that we fought for. Everything that the country stands for.
Tucker and his six top executives were indicted on 25 counts of fraud.
We, the jurors, find the defendant, Preston Tucker, not guilty.
Although found not guilty, the Tucker Corporation was over. The bogus lawsuit had driven the company under.
Tucker's American dream was crushed. There is suspicion that the big three motor companies in the U.S., Ford, General Motors, and Chrysler, were behind this. Either way, there were 51 Tuckers produced, and only 47 survive today, including number 28 here with you at the Maine Classic Car Museum.